Cycle Fever TV is brought to you by these great sponsors, so support them. Call Tough Turf for all your landscaping and irrigation needs. Check out Seminole Power Sports for all their brands of motorcycles, accessories, and service. DA's Cafe, where it's all happening. Bikes, cars, great food, rock and roll music. Come on by. USA Payroll, payroll tax service, workforce benefit solutions, insurance, and human resources. Check them out.
Stuff in it, some small cam, aluminum racing heads. And by the way, these aren't add-ons. These are actually 1970 hood pins. These are from the factory. All you do is just spin them, give them a little twist, and it opens right up. And you see, you got the little locks right up in here. The paint job is not original paint. I come up with the paint myself because I like to be something different. It's actually a real dark purple. It's not really got a name because me and the painter came up with it. It looks like it's black, but when in the sun, it'll pop up and it's a real, real dark purple. Tires are 17 inch with aftermarket Riddler rims. Interior is pretty much all original, except for I took out all the wood grain and put carbon fiber in it. It's got the factory AM 8-track radio in it. No FM, just AM, 8-track. Suspension is still pretty much the same. I replaced the shocks on it. It's got lowering springs on it to make it sit down a little bit lower. I've owned this car almost 7 years. After 2 years, we decided we were going to take it off the street and restore it. It took about 2 years to restore it, and been enjoying it ever since. Those headlights are actually halogen, and they got a LED strip around them. They will change 16 different colors. They're from Redline Lumtronics. Factory headlights on these cars weren't so great, so then I was going to get some halogens. Start looking at halogens, and then I seen these, and they just had the white stripe like all the new cars have, you know, the white little thing on it. But these actually change different colors. So then I can change them to whatever color I want to. That'll give you a quick of all the different colors that they change. And what I really like about 1970 vehicles, they're not just the body style, but they actually came from the factory with what they used to call window slats, or what we say, louvers. A nice rear wing, and it even has a front spoiler on the thing too. And if you look kind of close, you can see I like this place.
Hey everybody, Sean here from Psycho Fever TV. As you know, we're not just a bike show here. We do other things, especially out here at the Ace Cafe. And today is the 1 year anniversary out here at the Ace Cafe, and they actually have a bunch of cars in here. And I'm with Nick and Michael, not Mike, because that would be his dad, but this is Michael, so I just want to be sure I know who I'm talking to. And these guys have two beautiful Mustangs out here, so we decided to have a talk to them. So I'm gonna start with you, Nick. Nick, what got you into this?
My dad's always been big in the car world. He's always preferred Camaros, but then I came along and we've been starting to get more towards the Mustangs. I had a 14 before this one. This one's a 2013.
Yeah.
And then I convinced him to get a 2016 for his next car instead of buying a Camaro or a truck.
So is that what he's doing?
And that's what he's doing now. Now he's even looking at the Ford trucks and stuff.
All right.
I think I've converted him.
All right. Very nice. All right. And then now, did you get this car stock? What'd you have to do with it?
I just bought this car just recently. This is stock so far. This is wheels, the appearance, the motor, the supercharger. It's all stock. It has an upgraded phase 3 from the phase 1, so it's putting down 675 horsepower and 585 torque. Well, that's just a factory option from Roush.
We can't let Hank behind the wheel of this.
It gets to 55 real quick.
Real quick. And that's all you need to do, 55, 65, right?
Right.
All right. Well, beautiful car, beautiful car. Let me see. Michael, tell us a little bit about your beast here.
All right, well, I got a Holley Sniper intake manifold. As of right now that I know of, I'm probably one of the only ones in Florida that has it, and one of the only probably 10 people I know of in the state. Oh, not state, in the country.
You're the only one I know of.
Yeah, I'm okay. One in Florida, and then there's only a couple people in the country I know that have it.
So tell me, so what's that do?
Basically, it's just more bringing more air into the engine, more air, more fuel, better power. I got that mixed with some Stainless Works long tubes, no catch. I like to make loud noise. And basically, I'm pushing around, I don't know, about close to 500 to the wheels, about 530, 525 to the crank, and about, I don't know, 450, 425 torque.
And you follow the speed limit too, right?
No.
No, okay. Just checking. Well, listen, so what got you guys, and I'm going to start over here with you, what got you into the Ford, you know, just the Mustangs themselves?
Well, I used to race when I was a kid. I ran from quarter mids to legend cars to late models. I've raced NASCAR drivers, Chase Elliott and all them, Ryan Blaney. And I've always been around cars. My grandpa had the 64 Corvair that he gave me. I bring it to some car shows, but I haven't gotten to run in a while because I got my Mustang. What really got me the Mustang was my uncle. He had a 02 GT, nothing special, but he's always taking me when I was like 3, 4, 5 years old. He used to take me out to these alleyways in St. Petersburg and just do burnouts and stuff. And I just always loved cars. And as I just got older, I started buying trucks and I got tired of trucks. And I just want to have something more fun. And there's nothing to me that's more fun than just having like a manual Mustang to whip around town.
Hey guys, this is what I'm going to tell you. families that do things together like this, whether it's bikes, me and my dad, or you guys with these cars, it's just something special. I hope you guys really appreciate that, and I appreciate, and we at Cycle Fever TV appreciate the fact that you let us take some time and talk about your I almost said bikes, but your cars. That's something I'm used to saying. Nick?
Thank you.
Pleasure. Michael? Pleasure. Thank you, guys. All right, everybody. Cycle Fever TV, again, Ace Cafe. Come on down. There's always something going on.
There you go.
That's what we've been saying all along. You got to look at the map. I mean, on the map. On the
calendar.
I'm so used to looking at the
website.
Yeah, looking on the calendar. Because you never know what's going to happen.
They've always got something.
And I think them guys taught a little bit more than we know about Mustang.
Yeah, listen. Nick and Michael, they schooled me on the Mustangs. I admit it up front. I didn't know much about cars. But they did school me pretty good.
It's still not as bad as when JD was here and picked up the only Seville in the market.
Yes, right. For Fortnite, right? Yeah, he pulled off the Chevy. Yeah. So we'll never let him forget that one. So, yeah, no, again, like Mark said, there's always something going on here. Check the calendar. There's going to be a day or time for you to do something.
Just go to Google Ace Cafe. You go to Ace Cafe on their Facebook. Check it out.
Yep.
And while you're on Facebook, don't forget to look up Cycle Fever TV.
Exactly. So look for doing that. All right, so the next clip we're going to throw it to, this was last week. This was last Thursday's bike night. And so HD and Shaggy, they have a sound off there out there for the bike. So these guys pull out with some hardcore audio systems, right?
I remember one time we were sitting out there, we were listening to the Beautiful Bastards in the parking lot, and one of these guys pulled in, and the band had to quit playing because you couldn't hear the band in there. And, you know, they're just so loud.
So what they do is they have all the bikes can enter that want to enter, and then they narrow it down. So what you're going to see here is that it was getting narrowed down, and it was out quite a while last week. But you'll see what happens at the end here for the winner. I'll talk about that afterwards. So,
all right.
Tara, go ahead.
Let's
and
check it out.
Right here.
He's from West Coast, right? Sarasota, Bradenton.
run to the dance floor.
See me grabbing on my toy. She told me smack her on the booty. She said I got too many. She said I got too many shots.
So she turns here, right here, between this black roadblock and that beautiful Yamaha.
This is simply the most famous motor diner on the planet. Born in 1938 in London, England, it was notorious as a place for teenage rockers to hang out on motorbikes. Here in Orlando today, this is the first Ace Cafe in the USA. We're a restaurant, a bar, a concert hall, a place to shop. Basically, we're a gathering place for anybody who likes bikes, cars, and rock and roll.
When builders around this area need landscaping, they turn to Tough Turf Incorporated. Why? Because Tough Turf has been providing landscaping, irrigation, lawn maintenance, and lighting to residential and commercial builders and even homeowners associations for more than 20 years. As a family-owned business, we take great pride in making sure our employees approach each and every job with an exceptional level of experience, quality, and integrity. Tough Turf. When it comes to landscaping, nobody's tougher.
Seminole Power Sports. Number one in fast fun. Seminole Power Sports.
There's a whole lot of opportunity out there, and as the owner of your own business, that's what you need to be focusing on. Not payroll, hiring, and compliance. That's what we do. We're USA Payroll, and we started our business in 1994. So we've been there. We understand the growing pains and the not enough hours in the day that come with owning a business. So let us provide you with another opportunity. Help. We're USA Payroll, keeping your business in check.
He brought somebody important with him.
Absolutely.
There we go. He always does.
I don't know about all that.
To my left, which is to your right, I've got Jerry Strickland. He's the state leader for an amazing veteran-related nonprofit organization. I have been following this group. They're based out, I think it's Oregon?
Yes.
And,
some good stuff.
But they do amazing. What we do at United States Motorcycle Charities pales in comparison to what they do. He's with Mission 22. I'm going to let him kind of go into and share with what your mission is all about, brother. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you. I appreciate it. How's it going, everybody? Like you said, my name's Jerry. I'm with Mission 22. I am the North Florida state leader. Basically, with Mission 22, we help bring awareness that 22 vets take their life every day. On top of bringing awareness, we do something about it. We offer programs for PTSD and brain injury treatments. Our biggest program that we have is called the WIN program. We shortened it down. It's got a couple of hard names I can't even say. But basically, it's a program the vet does not have to leave their house. We can do it all online, Skype, Facebook Live, Zoom. There's 101 of them out there. Basically, the vet will come in, they'll do a blood sample, send it in. We'll see where their highs and lows are, because believe it or not, whenever they do have a with PTSD, they'll be high on magnesium or low on something else. And then we start sending them stuff. And a lot of the stuff that we send is an over-the-counter vitamin. And then we start working with them with their diet, and then we do the Facebook Lives or the Zoom videos and all, and that's part of their therapy. And it's a 12-month-long process, and it is all paid for through Mission 22.
Wow.
So, I mean, that's the thing. Whenever we bring a vet into any of our programs, all their expenses are paid, so we take care of it. Now,
fantastic.
You can go to mission22.com.
Yeah, before you go into that, I want to reiterate. It is 100% free to our veterans, meaning Mission 22 is picking up that tag.
Yeah.
So go ahead and give your website, because, hey, look, a lot of people are afraid to partner with other nonprofits. Look, my nonprofit, we receive donations, and we do what we do with motorcycle events. You know what? I'm not ashamed to introduce other guys and give out their website. Donate to this company. Go ahead and have
that. That's what it's amazing. About, well, our website is mission22.com. If you are a vet that does have PTSD or a brain injury and you are reaching out to us for help, you can go to mission22.com, scroll down to the bottom, and you can submit your application. Now, I will tell you, as I am a state leader, we are always looking for ambassadors.
That's right.
So another thing that you can do, if you want to get involved with Mission 22, go to mission22.com, and then at the bottom it says ambassadors. Click on it, fill it out, and that's the thing. I mean, we need active ambassadors to come here, right. Hang
help
out with these cool guys.
Help out.
I mean, help bring awareness. Help out. I mean, yeah.
It's just like we were talking about it at the baseball field. People don't realize what's going on out there. They don't
right.
see it.
Yeah, it's a blind eye.
Exactly.
Thing.
Yes.
Right.
I mean, that's why we're out here. I mean,
we got to get the word out.
Exactly. Now, I gotta tell you guys, I know y'all are a bunch of motorcycle guys and stuff, and I love bikes. I mean, me personally, I can't drive one, so I got a Jeep with no top on it.
No, he's got a badass Jeep. Let's go ahead and be honest. He's got a badass
right.
Jeep.
Hey, that's all right, because at the Ace, it's Jeep night, Porsche
right.
night. They got everybody's
everything.
Love well, here. We love motors.
Yeah, but here's the thing. It's not just a Jeep night. We have a truck and Jeep show this Saturday. Out here at Ace Cafe.
There you go.
Full show and shine. We'll have
come
the trophies and all that.
Oh, man. Come on down.
What are you guys doing?
Hey, you know what? I wish I could come to that, but I'll be moving my daughter out of her college dorm. So I'd much rather be
hanging. She must be at UCL.
No, she's actually at FSU. And then the next weekend, I got the one at UF. And then I go back to FSU. So
I'm not looking forward to that.
Next 3 weeks, you're going to kill me. I'd much rather be with you, Jerry.
Yeah.
Next weekend. Come on down.
Come on down. Yeah.
No, it's this Saturday.
This Saturday.
What's the name of the event?
It is Crawl for Mission 22.
Crawl for Mission 22, and I believe proceeds that are generated from that event are going to Mission 22.
It's a $10 fee to come in, and it is 100%. You pay $10, you can cash or card to come into the event, and all of the entry fees go straight to Mission 22. This is not an Ace Cafe. They said, hey, guys, come in. We're all about Mission 22 and helping our vets, so that's, I mean, much much love to A's
Here's
Cafe.
Here's what I'd like you to do, Jerry. Take some pictures and we'll put them up there.
Oh, that's
all
right.
Get us some pictures, send them to us, and we'll put them up there for
you. Yeah. He knows my wife, Heidi, is awesome at taking pictures and reaching out to people.
Good.
I just met him 2 days ago. I reached 2 days ago because his wife reached out to me on Facebook.
So, yeah. All right. Now, I do follow your guys' show.
Oh, thank you.
And I heard something about some patches.
Yeah.
Crazy John. Crazy John, what a challenge.
Well, before we do that, you're a nonprofit raising money.
Yeah, we are a 501c3.
Well, we're going to give you that for your donation to your from Cycle Fever TV.
I appreciate
Crazy John for you a little bit. Spread the wealth.
Crazy John, Cycle Fever, the first $100 to Mission 22. There's a challenge. He's issuing a challenge. Go to his website, Mission 22, and donate.
Donate the money.
And I'll tell you what, dude,
you don't even have to check that one with the little marker.
That was legit. That was real.
I got one of them black markers.
Now, the ones from me and Mark are different. They're hand-colored. We haven't got it down yet.
Been in the laundry a couple times.
We're having a problem with the chips in the dryer, but we'll get it worked out. We'll get back to you. So you talked about some patches. What we got?
We have a Mission 22.
Nice.
There you go.
Very good.
There you go.
All right.
So he's followed the site. He brought in a Mission 22 patch.
Look at that.
Again, this is for the Snowball Express children. 800 Gold Star children will be flying to Orlando, Florida, Disney World this December. We're providing them with their leather cuts. That's why we're asking for patches to be donated. The children will go ahead and select their patches, design their vests. We'll have them sewn on. So, hey, brother, we greatly appreciate it.
Thanks for having me, brother.
This is also the beginning of a great friendship and a relationship working together, brother.
Listen, here's what I hope, all right? Yes, I hope you have to change the name. That's what I want.
To Mission Zero.
I want it to go down every year. That's my wish and my dream.
That is our goal.
You've got to change that every year because, again, we talk about it with Rick. Talking about with Jeremy, talking about everybody else. They had our backs. They take care of us.
Right.
Now it's time to take care of them. Listen,
step up.
It's not like a broken arm, broken leg that you see, but they need the help. They need all of our help, and I hope they ask. Right? That's the key. Please ask. We want to help everybody, and with great events like this and charities like this, you have a place to go. Please don't be afraid.
And that's why I wear this camo silicone ring on my trigger finger. It's PTSD awareness. And it becomes a conversation piece.
Yeah.
People always say, hey, what is on your finger? It's a camo silicone ring, and I tell them how I love our veterans, we support our veterans, but I wear the trigger finger as an indication of, unfortunately, the tragic incidents of 22 veterans a day taking their own lives.
Yeah.
So we appreciate your mission and what you guys do, brother.
Way too many.
That's the best thing about coming out to our events. I mean, we did a PTSD walk for a lady over at Patrick Air Force Base. And it's not just bringing awareness. It's we work with the community. We work for, if something does tragic happen, we work with the families and stuff because it takes a community to heal a warrior. And then it also takes a community to heal everybody else and the family and stuff as well. I mean, unfortunately, it does happen. So we're an outlet for the families to reach out, and we can help them through their problems and tragic as well.
Fantastic.
So, I mean, just anything, come out and help.
And that's what it's all about. Everybody help.
It's all about helping out.
Before you head off, because I know you're going to head off, you're going to bring someone else on.
Right.
But Mark's got a little something for you right here.
We got some more patches for you.
Oh, come on, Mark. Look at that. Absolutely. Kids love the American flag. Absolutely, brother. That is awesome. That's what it's all about. It's not about United States Motorcycle Corps Charities. It's about the 800 kids who have lost their father, their mother, a family member, serving and protecting you, me, and our country.
All of us. The reason we get to do what we're doing right now.
Right. We're doing this because their parents, their loved ones, they paid the ultimate sacrifice in Iraq and Afghanistan, and that's why these kids are coming to Disney World, and that's why we're doing what we do. So I appreciate it, brother. That's awesome.
Right.
Jerry, awesome. Well, I don't want you to leave. I want to talk to you before the end of the night, but we're going to go ahead and, thank you very much for coming.
Thank you, Jerry. Thank you very much,
buddy. We'd like to have you on here more often, so this isn't just a one-and-done thing, okay?
Yeah. I'll see you again, man.
Good luck Saturday.
Saturday. Take us pictures. patches. We'll talk later on. Don't leave. I want to talk to you.
So now we're doing patches, so that's a perfect segue,
well,
right?
Since we're doing patches and you gave, Jerry gave Mission 22, Mark gave us American flag patches, Crazy John's the one who put out the challenge.
Yep.
So we're going to bring somebody by the name of George Colella. He is with Boots on the Ground, Bikers for Trump. George, why don't you come over here, buddy?
Come on out here, George.
George,
get out of the way, man.
How are you, George? Love you, brother. He's my guy. I call him Godfather. That's his patch name.
There you go.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm aggravated because he's going to Italy.
Like, I know.
I'm not gonna see Trump. Man, we got a few patches handed.
Look at this.
Thanks,
look at that,
There's a total of 150 in here.
He's got 150 patches.
150 patches.
Fire department.
Harley Davidson, U.S. Marines.
Wow.
That's awesome.
What do we got here?
Why don't you tell us exactly a little about yourself, what you do, and how did you hear about this patch challenge?
The patch challenge I heard about was from Rick. We were 2 weeks ago at the baseball field?
Yeah.
Bikes at the ballpark.
Bikes at the ballpark.
I also have my camo ring right there.
Yeah.
And it was a great honor to be there. I brought about 50 bikers there from our organization to participate in this wonderful event for our Gold Star moms and for the children that were around. So what happened was I requested anybody that knew had patches and stuff, and they brought it to me, and that's what we did. We brought them here for the well, we call these things a cut, but they're the vest. They're going to be donating vests to the with the Stonewall Express,
right?
And the patches will be put on. The kids go crazy with these patches right on their vests.
Right.
They really feel honored to have them on them, and it means a lot to them because of the sacrifice their mother or their father or family member that sacrificed their life for our freedom.
Right.
Which I am a World Trade Center survivor. I was on the 7th floor when the planes hit, but it's a mission. I mean, God made me give my life again, so I was saved, and I do a mission to do everything I can for veterans and for God and country and flag.
For country.
That's great.
Now, tell us about your group, if you can.
Yes, the Trump was established at the time, Boots on the Ground Bikers for Trump, with Trump running for office, and how we decided to get all the bikers we can together and help him get elected because of the mission that he has for our country and for our veterans, which he's been completing his jobs that he's saying that he was going to do. He's the only president that has kept all his promises, but we still don't understand why people are so much against him. But he's doing what he's supposed to do. And the most important thing is to take care of the veterans. That's what our mission is on.
Right.
So there's a lot of things that were done by this president that we honor very much, and that's our mission. So it's boots on the ground, bikers for Trump.
Yeah, now George brought me on board. You know, obviously my nonprofit, since we are a 501c3, we cannot be politically active, can't be involved in any legislative action. So, you know, when I'm not a part of my nonprofit, of course I have my own personal life, I'm also part of Boots on the Ground, Bikers for Trump. And this Tuesday, we're providing a security detail for President Donald Trump. He'll be here in Tampa. Unfortunately, Godfather won't be here. He'll be in Italy.
Trying to be with the Prime Minister in Italy.
Yeah, so we'll be here with President Trump. We'll be here on Tuesday in Tampa. You're going to come out to do some filming for us. And then you've given me a patch name. What's my patch name?
Consulieri, the trusted advisor. And if he doesn't do a good job,
I'm in trouble.
But don't write any shirts for you guys.
I was doing the shirt for you guys.
Great. Thank you.
You got to find the right size.
Yeah.
It's a little bit too big for you.
Yeah, they'll probably help me.
No, I got large.
He's got
there
large.
There we go.
Bike,
thank you very much.
I got 2X. That's for the heavy guy over here.
Well,
who's the big boy?
You didn't think it was funny?
It's all right.
What are you laughing for? Why, you
he's,
too?
He's in
do
the tall.
Like a clown?
He's in the tall. In the tall one.
That's a skit from the Godfather.
No, he's too tall.
He's too tall.
He might not even have any friends.
I like you better when you sit down.
He's
up and hang out.
You gotta have some fun, right? Go ahead.
How tall are you?
About 6'3".
6'3".
Pretty cold.
Hey, look, check this out.
We're going to
get you up.
I feel like I'm sitting in a hole.
Well, obviously, we had a challenge that was issued, and it looks like we've got a winner. So what are we issuing for the $100 patch challenge?
There you go, John. There you go.
Isn't there something that we're still collecting, aren't we? But, I mean, we don't have.
Oh, there's something in there.
Yeah, there's something in there.
Oh, I want to donate this
patch.
No, that's next week. He didn't bring him this week. Yeah.
Oh.
So we had.
There you go.
John, what did you issue? Hang on. Tell him what you issued and what was
it. So here's what we did. So for the first week, whoever brings the most matches over 25, we get $100. Next week, whoever brings more than 50 that wins gets another $100. The following week, 75, and the following week, 100. Look, the whole object here is to bring patches. We need them for the kids. And I just wanted to donate and help people get patches. So, for tonight's winner, here is your... Oh, what the hell?
What happened?
Don't even cost the money.
Huh?
They switched the 20 to 100. I get it.
Did they really?
I don't know.
I should have brought the stamp.
I just had it.
Maybe.
Who took it?
Oh! There it is.
There it is. All right. So we gave $100.
I want to donate this to the motorcycle charities.
Oh, do you really?
There you go.
Wow. Okay.
You go.
So George, with Boots on the Ground Bikers for Trump, had over 100 patches, about 150. He's the winner of the $100 patch challenge. He, in turn, donated the $100 back to the United States Motorcycle Corps Charities. Brother, we greatly appreciate that, man.
Thank you, brother.
Love you.
Thank you for joining my guy from Yeti. He's doing a pretty good job. It's like,
don't screw up, because you know what happens, right?
No.
He's on temporary.
Just sad I'm not going to Italy with him.
Yeah,
George, thank you so much. We greatly appreciate it.
Thank you. Thanks for having me on.
No, thank you.
I appreciate it. Love everything you guys do.
Now, before you head out, we're just going to have you, because we're going to go to the Blue Ridge Parkway. So you're just going to tell Tara to run the clip. That's all you got to do.
We're going to the Blue Ridge Parkway. Tara, run the clip.
There we go.
There you go.
Everyone, this is Mark Hall with Mark Hall Riding and Flying. I'm working on the video for the Blue Ridge Parkway. Check it out. It's going to be on Cycle Fever TV Thursday night, which is tonight. So after the show, we're going to put it up on Facebook, on my Facebook. It'll also be on my YouTube channel. Again, it's Mark Hall Riding and Flying or Cycle Fever TV. If you get a chance, give us a like, a subscribe. If you can, that's a subscribe. If you didn't get that right, on YouTube, Mark Hall Riding and Flying. Blue Ridge Parkway video we're working on right now. Everybody enjoy.
couldn't go live because of no signal on top of the mountain. But I just wanted to stop just so everybody could get an idea of what it looks like riding on a foggy day. So, it is pretty dang foggy. But we are on top of a mountain. So, I guess a little bit of fog could be expected.
Okay, everyone, I hope you enjoyed the ride. Don't forget, go to my YouTube channel, Mark Hall Riding and Flying, and give me a like and a subscribe. Please check out Cycle Fever TV Live every week, Thursday night, 7:30 at the Ace Cafe, downtown Orlando. Again, that's Mark Hall Riding and Flying on YouTube. Go over to Cycle Fever TV, give them a like, give them a subscribe. Don't forget, we'll be at OB's filming January 19th live on YouTube for their live CD recording. We'll be at the Ace Cafe once again every Thursday night. That's Cycle Fever TV. They're on Facebook, they're on Twitter, they're on Periscope, they're on everything you could think of. So I'm glad I'm hooked up with them. Cycle Fever TV, Mark Hall Riding and Flying. Check us out.
So, that was a great ride. I don't know if you guys ever rode the Blue Ridge Parkway or not.
It's beautiful.
My brother did.
Just
actually,
my brother.
Beautiful.
My brother did.
Absolutely beautiful out there.
We had to go up there at the Gearhead Inn. We had them on the show a couple weeks ago.
We did.
Stayed up there, and we're actually planning another ride in October to go up there. If
now, is this one of your tours?
Yep.
All right, so how do they get in touch with you about doing
go
the tour?
Go to againstthewindfl.com. You look us up there, or you go to my Facebook page, Mark Hall Riding and Flying. Look us up there. We're booking tours now, so you check it out.
Yeah, Mark should be booking tours. All these different rides.
I got to tell you, at the Pierhead Inn, when you park there, you're 20 minutes away from the Blue Ridge Parkway. You're an hour away from Deal's Gap, where the Dragon Tail is. You're like 45 minutes away from the Devil's Triangle. And you're right down the road from the Moonshiner's Run, which is US 48. And that's where everybody goes. You see their bikes parked behind the waterfall. It's a great place to go. Yeah, down by Duke Falls.
The footage was great. It was crazy. How the fog rolled in, then it rained. Then an hour later, boom, just beautiful skies, right?
You know, I got on the Blue Ridge Parkway, and they shut it down that day.
Oh.
Because of the fog?
Yeah, because of the fog. So when I got to the end, I had to actually wait there for an hour for the guy to come open the gate so I could get through. Because when you're on the parkway, about every 100 miles, they have a gate there to shut it off, different miles. So I had to sit there and wait for the park ranger to let me off.
Nah, it's great. It's great. Everybody get with them about going on that tour, beautiful sightseeing. So listen, while that clip was playing, hopefully you noticed that when we got back, Crazy John, me, and Mark here all have a beautiful little
flag
ready. Open flag. So
Navy Mom
Mary.
Yep.
All right. She pinned these on us during the last
segment, the last clip.
Yep.
She's going to be on here.
Next week.
She gives these to Gold Star families and stuff like that. We saw her at the ballpark. So she's going to be out here next week, and she's got something important that she wants to announce. So we can't wait to get her back out there and she'll announce something.
Yeah.
She'll let you guys know what she's up to. So
it's a big thing.
No,
it was a great thing. And right now, we're going to bring in that guy they were ragging on earlier about being too tall.
Oh.
Because he has got a nice bike.
Yeah. Bike in a night.
Bike in a night.
He might have to squat down here with us.
Come on.
Henry, come on in here, buddy.
Stand next to the tall guy.
That's right. Between the two tall guys here. Henry, how you doing?
Doing great, sir.
All right. I'm doing good.
Hey, thanks for coming on.
Henry, nice meeting you guys.
This is Henry Rivera. Oh, there it is. His name's right on there, so that's easier to remember.
And I like the way he told us how to spell his name. River with an A.
Hey, he must have seen us before. So we were out there. Crazy John was doing his thing like he always does. He's walking around the parking lot. He spots a bike. We got that bike, and so here we are for Bike of the Night.
Yeah.
So, first night at the Ace. Been here before?
Been here a couple times before, yes, sir.
Okay, where are you from?
I'm from here, from Kissimmee, yes, sir.
You're right from Kissimmee? Okay, tell us about your bike a little bit.
It's a 2015 Honda CBR 1000, the Repsol edition. I've always loved that colorway, you know. My dream bike when I was, you know, young. This is how I got into bikes, you know. First dream bike, hopefully first of many.
The CBRs, they've been around for a long time.
Long time.
And, you know, you see a lot of these guys are out there doing the stunts. That's what they're riding. That's what they're riding right now.
So because tonight we got a little glitch going on a little bit. But now roll the video of the bike.
Now you said that's totally stock?
Bone stock.
It's slow, right? It's a very slow moving bike, right?
No.
Let everybody know what's the horsepower on it.
Horsepower looking at about 175 from that neighborhood.
Yep.
But right now it's just a blank canvas, you know.
And there's so much accessories for that bike. I mean, you go down to Seminole Power Sports, they're one of our sponsors, they've got so many things you can add to that bike. I mean, it's just unbelievable. They got a sports touring package that's really nice that goes on that bike up there.
Now, Henry, let me ask you something. Do you ride with a group? Is there a group or are you just...
No, sir. Unfortunately, all my friends like riding on four wheels.
Is that it? They're all cages.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right.
Say hello to my fiance Michelle and my son Ethan.
Hey guys, Michelle and Ethan.
Hello, Ethan. How are you?
Yes, sir. That's about it. I appreciate it.
Are you in the military?
No, sir, I would not.
Well, you can do a lot of sirring.
Yeah.
We're not sirs, that's for sure.
It's
but
respect.
We appreciate the respect.
I really do, because there's not
much out there anymore.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
So here's what you need to do. You need to tell as many people as you can to go on Cycle Fever TV. Okay, and vote for your bike, okay? Because whatever bike wins, one person that votes gets a prize, and whoever wins gets on the hall right here. They're going to put up Bike of the Month, and then at the end of the year, they're going to have Bike of the Year.
Now,
your bike can be on the wall here at the Ace Cafe.
Now, we have your email, right?
Yes, sir.
All right, so we'll shoot down an email when it's going out there, and then you get everybody out there. Everybody get out there and vote for Henry.
Next week starts the voting for the month of July. Make sure to tell all your friends, get your ass on a boat.
Cycle Fever TV on Facebook.
Go there,
go to the comments, and vote for which bike you like. So there you go.
All right.
Henry,
great things, buddy. We're going to let you get back out there to the party and your friends.
I wish I was your height, buddy.
Yes, it's that time of night.
I see things have a different light.
Thanks, Henry. So, all right. Well, let's get moving along there. So, you got some rides and events, right?
I've got a couple of them here. Let me get to them. The first thing I want to talk about is the Two Broke for Sturges. I remember last year we did a video on that. That was a good event. They had about 1,800 bikes show up for that. It's at the Pirates Pub. It's August 3rd through the 5th. All vendors are going to be, got about 50, 60 vendors going to be there, food, drink specials. And this is all put together by Rebel Rider Magazine. It's at the Pirates Pub. It's over in Paisley.
Paisley. Right there out of the land.
Yes, right outside of the land. Yep. It's August 3rd and the 5th. And then for those of you guys looking for parts or looking to build a bike, this is the largest swap meet there is. They do it once a month. It's going to be August 5th, this Sunday. It's at Webster. I mean, this swap meet's so big, they have campsites for it.
Yep.
So can't go wrong. It's over on 516 Northwest 3rd Street in Webster, Florida. And then
right.
I want to bring, is he over there still?
Michael?
Godfather. Godfather was on earlier. He's the guy with bikers on boots on the ground for Trump. He wanted to show his best, so we're going to go ahead and bring him in.
All right, straight to field. This way.
Yeah, we didn't get a chance. There you go. All right.
Don't forget, check them guys out.
All right.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Our last one is September 15th. This is the 14th annual USO benefit ride. It's out of Orlando Harley. Come out and check it out.
You'll be all right?
Excuse me, Bronson.
You gonna make it?
Yeah, Bronson Avenue. Or Bronson Memorial Highway.
Kissimmee.
All right, go ahead before I choke to death.
All right. Hey, we got, come on. Man, long time no see, guys.
Hey, yeah, we're back.
Yeah, well, I mean, I miss you.
I was hanging over the side of it. I was like, these guys are so good looking. I feel better looking hanging out with y'all. So I was like, man, I just got to get back in the mix.
There you go.
Well, right, now that you bullshitted us.
Yeah, I know.
Now
I want to do, first, thank you guys for letting me come on here. I mean, great show.
It's our pleasure.
Yeah. But I love the show, my love. So I got each one of you guys. I know manly men wear silicone.
That's it, baby.
Hey, this silicone I will
it's
wear.
It's on me.
All right.
Now.
This is an important one. I'm putting it on right now.
Now, with what I want you guys to do with that bracelet. Is, it actually says Mission 22,
yep.
helping United in the war against veteran suicide.
Yep.
Now, of course, that's what Mission 22's mission
is. Yep.
So the next time you're talking to a vet or something like that, and they're like, man, I was like, yeah, I've had PTSD. Like my man Rick over there has that trigger finger.
Yep.
Give them that bracelet. Let them know that they ain't the only one out there.
Yeah.
But they have support groups. So, and I know you guys love to talk on the radio and TV and stuff. So I'm gonna give you guys each information.
Nice, perfect.
And then I grabbed a couple T-shirts for you guys.
Oh man,
that's awesome.
I got a T-shirt night, isn't it?
Now, our shirts. You have to go to mission22.com.
Yeah, you can't buy this shirt at Walmart. Yeah. You can't go to Kmart and buy this. This shirt has meaning behind it.
Yeah.
You want to explain what this shirt's about. Yeah. So.
Our shirts are only sold at our event. Me being a state leader, I set up the full booth, and you come to our events, or you go to mission22.com, and you can buy our gear there. We will not sell it in like a bulk store, because you know what? This shirt means something.
Yeah.
It has heart.
Yeah, it does.
It has heart.
I mean, and when we sell it, we sell it with the meaning, and we explain to you what Mission 22 is. And, I mean, this, when you buy our gear, it's helping pay for those PTSD and brain injury treatments.
Yep.
So, there's our beautiful shirts. I got you.
Very nice. Very nice.
Now, this
you can go on your website and buy it to help support, right?
Yes. And this one right here is actually one of our slogan shirts. It's, how do you heal?
You gave me something.
Yeah.
Hey, it don't get any better than this.
Yep.
So it's about
this,
folks.
This one right here is just our other standard Mission 22. I've got a couple sizes.
Yeah, awesome.
I mean, I know you like them form-fitting
didn't hide him.
He's got to show off that physique.
He's got that granddad. He likes sizes too small.
That's called the Stella physique.
Is that really high?
Yeah.
Don't even ask him about his underwear.
I think I saw that video where he had the American flag.
There's a reason he's Crazy John.
That's beautiful, guys. Thank you so much.
No, thank you.
Thanks for coming back out here. Thank you.
Appreciate everything you do.
Thank you for doing what you do.
And remember, this Saturday, come on out.
And again,
$10 to get in.
And all the money's going to Mission 22
all
for the
it.
Vets. That's mission22.com. Don't forget to check them out.
Which is great of Ace Cafe. Yep. Not taking anything. Everything's going fantastic.
And this, if you guys hadn't come here, I mean, this is my first time here. This place is awesome. I mean,
good.
They are set up.
Good.
I mean,
it's an awesome thing.
Yep. Yeah, I'm stoked.
Good.
Thank you.
That's it, man. Thanks, buddy.
I'll tell you what, I don't know if we need to keep going. We keep going, we'll have more shirts than we ever do.
Hey, I'm going to keep doing this, and I'll have a warning. I don't have to go anywhere to shop.
And every shirt's a good shirt, too.
We'll be all set to go. All right, what do you got for the from the Ace here for events going on?
So for the events going on, we got the Downtown Truck Show Friday. We got the July 27th, okay?
Which is this Friday.
Mm-hmm. Right? This Friday.
Yeah.
Tomorrow.
Okay. And then we got 365 Jeep Crawl, which is...
That's what he's talking about.
That's what he's talking about.
Mission 22,
right there.
People,
yeah. Mission 22.
And that's 4 to 11. 4 to 11, okay? And then we got Van Life. Sunday, July 28th, we got Honda Civic. Oh, July 28th, too. So we got 11 to 2 and 6 to 9.
There you go.
We got two things going
Working it. Look at that.
You can come here and have breakfast and dinner.
You got to mingle a little bit. We've seen that before, right?
Yeah.
We've seen cars, bikes, trucks, everything.
On Sunday, they've got one of the best, a really good Bloody Mary bar. You get your Bloody Mary, you just put whatever you want in it. From shrimp to bacon, it's over there.
There you go.
Then what do we got? Orlando?
What?
The Miatas?
Yeah, it says... I'm not sure if that's supposed to be Roadster Miatas instead of Roadster. I think it's supposed to be Roadster Miatas.
So we're going
to be here.
If you got a Miata, I'll bring it in.
Come on, check it out.
Hank did not do this.
No.
So I'm not going to blame you, Hank.
You know what? Yes, we are.
Yeah.
He's not here.
That
was the outset of the show.
That's
anything we're going to blame, we're blaming him for. We're not blaming Jeffy or anybody else here.
Hey, and then actually, we met him tonight. We met Trivia Tuesday.
Yeah, yeah.
He does stuff here.
Yeah, Curtis, right?
Yeah, he does stuff here where they get a company together and they do trivia night.
And it's like
a bonding for the company, which was pretty cool.
Yeah.
So you bring in your company?
Hell no. Coming soon. What is this?
Coming soon. We got too many vehicles in this.
All right.
So since it's summer's coming to an end, we got the school supply drive car show. So bring school supplies Saturday, August the 4th.
Yeah, and look at some nice cars.
11 a.m. to 2 p.m. to help NAP Ford. All right. So community school, NAP Ford, community school, and get 15% off your lunch.
There you go.
So that's it.
So bring in something, donate
supplies, get a discount on your lunch.
Can't go wrong with that.
Yep. And then shout outs. We got Indian Motorcycle. It's the official sponsor here at the Ace Cafe.
Yep.
Right?
Set up every night. You come by and look at what they got.
Dionysi.
Talk to some sales reps.
Yep.
Dionysi.
Leather.
And you don't need to have it on a bike.
Maybe we
you
keep talking. They'll bring some of that out. Right? We keep talking. Maybe they'll bring some of that out. We got High Motorsports. We got Orlando Harley Davidson. Cycle Fever TV.
That's us.
And Hart and Huntington Tattoos. They're downstairs here.
Brand new here. Come out and check them out.
Check them all out. Ace Cafe wants to be sure and let people know about them. So that's it for that.
That's it.
Time for the end of the night. What
are
we going to say?
Well, we are going to look into the camera.
Hey, one other thing.
Next week,
we need 50 or more again. We're going to give out another $100. Okay? We need you to bring patches. If we put
I got to admit, man. So he's helping us.
He's donating, so we need to get him some.
I got to do it. I'm sorry.
All right, you guys ready?
Ready?
Yeah. Tell us to wrap it up.
Wrap it up, man.
All right, everybody. So listen.
Hey. Join
the
event.
I thought you were going to tell me something. It's one of those nights, everybody.
Hey.
We will see you next Thursday. We appreciate you. Thank you very much. So, everybody, join the event
and enjoy the ride.
See you next week.